I want to give all honors and praises and glory belongs to my Lord and Savior, whose name is Yahawah, Bahasham, Yahawashi, Bahasham, Wahavakak. But that's the name of the Heavenly Father is Yahawah, and his son's name is Yahawashi. And whom we reverence and honor to the elder apostles that told me this truth of great millstone, and to the hopeful and elect across the globe, and to the few, the very few brothers and sisters that are listening and learning across the globe. This lesson is going to be called, they didn't have, look, they were mad at the idea of grace being shown. The chief priests and the Pharisees, they were mad at the idea of particular member being shown grace and mercy. Let's go to Mark 2 and 16. Here we go. This is Mark 2, let's start at 14. And as he passed by, he saw Levi, son of Alphaeus, sitting at the seat of the custom, okay, and said unto him, follow me, and he arose and followed him. And this Alphaeus, he was working for the Romans, he was what? Collecting taxes for the Romans, okay? And it came to pass that as Yahawashi sat at the meat in his house, many publicans were tax collectors, debt collectors, just like today, they're not, debt collectors are very hated. They get attacked, all types of things happen to them. Okay, those that collect what? Debt for the state. Okay. Many publicans and sinners sat also together with Yahawashi and his disciples. So they were sitting with him, eating, and not just physically eating, spiritually eating. Yahawashi was supping with them. Okay. But there were many and they followed him. So this is the whole premise that yes, you're a sinner, but the main thing is admitting it. So these men, they were humble enough, and Yahawashi saw something within them that they were repenting, or even sat down with them. And when the scribes and Pharisees saw him eat with the publicans and the sinners, okay, and it says saw him, because they were, you notice one thing, they were always there. They were always there. Wherever Yahawashi was, they were there. It was like they were spying. They were watching him. Just like you have individuals, demonic ass individuals that sneak on our page and watch everything we do and we say. And when the scribes and the Pharisees saw him eat with publicans and sinners, they said unto his disciples, how is it that he eateth and drinketh with publicans and sinners? So they were mad. And that showed you what spirit they were in. That's like anybody coming up to me and they're having trouble with something and me saying, you know what, I'm not going to deal with you because you sinned. So that showed you what spirit they were in. It's like they were jealous. And these men were shown grace. And when Yahawashi heard it, he saith unto them, they that are whole have no need of a physician, a healer, because you're whole. And see, this is why Yahawashi deals with the lowly. It's the ones that are sick. It's the ones that need help. That's what he uses. The ones that are not popular. But they that are sick. Okay? That's to be careful. They that are sick. And these individuals were acknowledging they're sick. That's the first part of this truth. Admitting that you have a problem. Men can't do that. That's why they don't grow, and that's why Yahawashi can't deal with them. I came not to call the righteous, because why did Yahawashi say I came not to call the righteous? Because by their statement about eating and drinking with publicans and sinners, they were already righteous in their own mind through the law. This is why I always say you always put Yahawashi first, because he comes in the volume of the whole book. The law is secondary; faith comes first. So that's why Yahawashi said, I came not to call the righteous, because they were righteous in their own eyes. They were self-righteous, but the sinners to repentance. And it's the same thing when I'm on a highway with the sinners. But those that admit their faults, those that want to repent, not those that are acting holier than thou, but really they're wicked. Okay? This is what this truth is about. Okay? Why? Because once upon a time, you didn't know about the truth. You were going off. And guess what? You still go off. That's That's why we have to be humble. Bear me just a minute. This is that Mr. That's that hypocrisy. They were coming with. Okay? And the scriptures do say, bear me just a minute. Let's go to, you gotta be careful. There is a wicked man that hangeth down his head sadly. You know what? Let's start at 25. There is an equisite subtlety, and the same is unjust. So you could be doing something subtle, but what way are you doing it in? You could be doing it some type subtle, because scripture talk about being subtle servants, but you could be doing it in wickedness. And there is one that turneth aside to make judgment appear, which is corruption. And there is a wise man that justifies in judgment. And ultimately, the elect are justified by Yahawashi. There is a wicked man that hangeth down his head. You gotta watch out for that. A man that's always hanging down his head. Sadly. So why? To give you that illusion that he's humble when he's not humble. But inwardly he is full of deceit. Inwardly. And that's why Yahawashi was always thinking about the inward and outward man. He was always thinking about the inward man. But inwardly, see, that's Satan. Sorry about that, that's Satan. But inwardly, he's full of deceit. Slamming the door like a gorilla on the heat. But you see, the demons get... See what I mean? When you're teaching this word, it's entirely, the demons get upset. But inwardly, he is full of deceit. So our people, this thing about our own people, they're full of deceit. And you can also paint this with me, so they're full of deceit inwardly. Passing down his countenance. Acting like you're pseudo humble. No, you're made humble in this truth. Yahawashi has to make you humble. He has to humiliate you, so you're humble. And make it, like it, and make it as he had heard not. When he is not knowing, he will do the mischief. When the right opportunity comes, before thou be aware. And if for want of power he be hindered for sinning, yet when he find an opportunity he would do the evil. This is speaking about our own people. And it's the same thing with the Pharisees. They were acting righteous, but they were wicked. They were not ready about the truth. They were not teaching the most important matters. Mercy, judgment, faith. Let's go to John 1. And they were not confessing their sins before Yahawashi. If we could, this is John 1 and 9. If we confess our sins, that's the first part of look, that's the first part of even waking up to the truth. You wake up to the truth because you realize we were wrong. We were going off. That's the first part of the truth. So how can you come into the truth if you ain't confessed your sins? How can you even get into a camp if you have not confessed your sins? Because if you don't confess it now, Yahawashi will just, look, Yahawashi will just expose you and that's it. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us of our sins. That's why this is about confession. To Yahawashi. That's where that mercy shows. He forgive us of our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Not some, all. If we say that we have not sinned, we make him a liar. So basically, you're calling Yahawashi a liar. His word is not in us. That's why you have to be real. That's why you have to be sincere about this truth. Because if you're not, you're going to be found out. And I'm finding out, yeah, there's more fakes in this truth. A lot of fakes. A lot of phonies. Let's go to Ecclesiastes 7 and 20. For there is not a just man upon earth that doeth good. But there is a just man. And sinneth not. So there is a, it says, that for there is not a just man. Just man means righteous. And to be righteous means you're balanced. Upon earth that doeth good. Because they're just, because they're doing good. But and sinneth not. So you're going to have just men. They went off in David. Several men that went off in the spirit. Even Yahawashi back at what Solomon. Does that mean he wasn't just? No, Solomon was just. Solomon was Yahawashi. Okay. This is where self accountability comes in. But a lot of men, They don't take self accountability for nothing. That's why Yahawashi was what dealing with what those that were meek, those that were able to acknowledge, you know what, I messed up here, but I need a savior. Okay, and that's why the wicked of our people are going to have to be destroyed on this side, because they don't want to acknowledge Yahawashi. Okay, they proclaim their own righteousness. Let's go to Matthew 23. Oh man, all that 23. Why would you scribes, Pharisees, hypocrites, being paid tithe of mint and anise, coming and having omitted them? Weighty matters of the law. Weighty is heavy. These are heavy matters. The law, judgment, mercy. This is the law and faith, the most important thing. These all you can have done, and not to leave the other undone. So men, they put all the other stuff, the prophecies, which is good, because we have to go into prophecy, but they leave out the most important matters. Judgment, mercy, and faith, the right judgment. These all you can have done, and not to leave the other undone. And being partial, you leave one after the other. You blind guys that strain at a gnat and swallow a camel. Blind guys, okay, blind leaders. They strain at a gnat, the smallest of matters, and swallow a camel. Why would you swear to God, you not seen outside of the cup? So these are men that have the outward appearance, and not the platter, the plate, but within you are full of extortion, which is corruption, in other words. Okay, so you've got men, they're full of corruption. Okay, they're full of iniquity, and that corruption and hypocrisy. Okay, that's why you have to say beware of the leaven of the Pharisees. I mean, it's in the international version, it says lawlessness. That's what it says in the international, lawlessness. So they had one rule for you, but behind closed doors they had another rule for themselves. But within they are full of extortion and excess. Thou blind Pharisee, cleanse first that which is within the cup, yourself. Make sure you're right within yourself. And the platter that is outside of them may be clean also. That's what you do. Okay? You wash the inside. Alright, you don't have a wash. You just put your clothes on. Well, you're still dirty because you didn't wash. But your clothes might be clean, but you didn't wash. So it's the same with this truth. How shall a man cleanse his body by taking heed to according what to the word? By taking heed to Yahawashi. But the Pharisees, they were not taking heed to Yahawashi. They were taking heed to the law, but they were not taking heed to Yahawashi. Okay? Woe unto you, scribes, Pharisees, hypocrites, you are like whited sepulchres, which indeed appear beautiful outward, but within full of dead man's bones, which have ear unclean. And what's in that tomb? What dead man's bones? Wickedness. Even so, you also outwardly appear righteous unto men. See, when you're sincere, you don't need to outwardly appear righteous. Your works are going to speak for you. Your actions are going to speak for you. So you don't need to do all this extra stuff. But within, you're full of hypocrisy and iniquity. That's why, on this side, Yahawashi is only dealing with an elect. Okay? Until the next time, I hope this is edifying. Inshallah.